Good morning, everybody. This is Camo Dave. This is a channel called Kotaku. It's a news channel that covers anime and stuff like that. This guy, Mark Fitzgerald, he runs a channel called Totally Not Mark. He has well over 500,000 subscribers. Anyway, he does reviews of anime, mainly Japanese anime videos, and he does one a week, and he's done them for 3 years, and he's done real well with them, gets a lot of views. He has a team working with him. He makes some good money. And anyway, so everything's been going cool for the last few years until a few days ago when he starts to get a bunch of copyright claims. Now, a copyright claim is different than a copyright strike. A copyright strike, it can take your channel down. You get three of them and YouTube can shut your channel down. So if you're using somebody else's copyright, you know, even a couple seconds of some videos, they can file a strike and then you get a black mark on your channel, and after three of those, you're gone. These are called copyright claims. What a copyright claim is that they're just claiming the copyright, but you can keep your video up. The negative part of that is you lose your monetization, and that money you were making on your video goes to the claimant. Okay? Copyright claims are actually way more common, and most everybody, every YouTuber has probably gotten a couple copyright claims, if not a couple strikes. But a claim, you know, for instance, you're recording something at a restaurant and there's background music, and they'll hit you with a claim that, oh, you can keep your video up, but the company that, you know, has the copyright to that song in the background wants your revenue. So Mark says that he has his team and his business that he's running is in danger now. There's a company called TOEI, T-O-E-I, that that owns copyright to all these Japanese anime videos, or a good chunk of them. He likes to do Dragon Ball, I believe it's called Dragon Ball, yeah. So all of a sudden, after doing 3 years of these videos, he starts to get these claims popping up, you know, couple one night, and then all of a sudden from 15, it jumps up to 150. So his videos can stay up, I presume. If you go to his channel and look at it, they're all still up there. But Totally Not Mark is his channel. This is it here. He has 636,000 subs. His videos seem to be staying up. You know, 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, 13 days ago, whatever. But he's not making any money on him anymore. So unless he settles this out with the company there or whatever, or changes what he's doing, you know. Now, me, your Camo Dave, I've done reviews too. And what happened to me about a year ago is that, you know, I'm doing, you know, people say, go ahead and use my videos. That's okay. I use little snippets, whatever. And all of a sudden, somebody gets mad at you or gets in a dispute with you and starts filing copyright strikes. And, you know, you gotta, you know, your channel gets a couple strikes and, hey, it could go away. So, you know, all it takes is one person or one company or one dispute, and you can have big problems. So, anyway. So that is one of the reasons why I've stopped using clips and taken down most of the videos that had clips. Anyway, so just, again, it takes one company, one dispute, one person that, you know, wants to get you can do that. So you got to protect yourself. So anyway, Mark now has to make some changes in his channel. He hasn't posted anything since his last video here, which is telling about what's going on here. The other interesting thing is, too, that copyright rules are different in different countries. Japan apparently does not have a fair use thing like we have here in the United States of America. And even here in America, you can claim fair use, but you know, if the copyright claimant disagrees with you, they can still file a strike or a claim, and YouTube just kind of throws up its hands and says, well, whatever. You know, so YouTube will not, you know, even if in a lot of cases, if you're technically fair use, you don't have a lot of defense, at least with YouTube here in the States. Anyway, so Japan has different rules, England has different rules, all the countries have different copyright rules, and so if a Japanese company wants to come after you for copyright, and you're in America, and what are you going to do? YouTube will just say, okay. So anyway, the good news is pretty much his channel's still up. It's not in danger. He's got a good chunk of his videos still up, but he's not making any money and monetizing them, and he's going to have to figure out a way to get around that. And one of the ways is just stop using the clips. So we'll see. Or make a deal. Or he can make some sort of a deal with TOEI, T-O-E-I, maybe to allow him to continue using their clips. All right, so that's the latest. If we hear more about it, we shall let you know. And let's jump over to the Nomads real quick here. What do we got here? Again, things are pretty slow, and that is not unusual for this time of year. More and more Nomads are heading down to the Quartzsite area. Everybody and his brother's down there. Not Unstoppable Morgan. She is continuing to work to build out her Bronco slide out, where she'll have a bed back there. She bought a second Bronco, so we got a new video from her. It is Vlogmas, Christmas vlogging, where these people are doing videos every single day up through the 24th of, which is Christmas Eve of December. And so she is busy building out, with her welding abilities now, the frame for her Bronco slide out. He hasn't posted this new thing yet, but a huge lizard motorbike crash in Thailand. 30 and a wake up Kevin. Not clickbait. So Kevin there, this Kevin, 30 and a wake up, he is down in Thailand. He's been down there for quite a while now. And apparently he ran into a large critter, a lizard. And it caused him to somehow crash his motorbike. His video comes up tonight. Oh, it's actually coming up at 9 a.m. our time, so that'll be an hour and a half from now, so maybe I'll report on it later, but he looks like he's uninjured. He's standing there with his helmet on. I wonder if that's a Photoshop picture or not. We don't know. Wayward Wags are in Vegas! Yeah! Got a new one from Hobo Shoestring, our favorite train-hopping hobo. He is busy getting a lot of things taken care of at his home base there in Tennessee. Regarding his health, he has a bunch of tests coming up, and they keep putting them off and dragging them out. God. Nomadic Dramatic, what's his name? The guy we don't talk about anymore, Derek Eric. Texas-sized ideas lead to slight regrets. He's down in Texas now, by the way. RV drums. So he got these electronic drum set, vintage electronic drum set, and he's got the Christmas tree up, got the big 70-inch TV up, and he is parked down in Texas right now. So he needs a bigger RV. He can get another. Why doesn't he get two Class A's? Can you tow one Class A behind another Class A? Or he could get a huge trailer to put all his stuff in. I guess she's reacting to the fact that I'm not there anymore. I'm not in Arizona anymore. So what is she doing? This is Marie. Marie, RV camper Marie. She is taking a really good look at where the RTR will be held. As we reported earlier a few days ago, Bob, Cheap RV Living, has announced that the RTR will be held, the seminars. He's pretty much just doing the seminars. It's going to be held in this Quartzsite Park, which is a couple miles from where most people are camping. There it is. And she says it's a really nice location, and it's not far from Quartzsite. Remember when Bob had the seminars a couple years back? They were up near La Paz Fairground, which was a good half hour, 40 minutes where is this place? Quartzsite. Anyway, so she checks out the camp, the fairground area, which is a park, Quartzsite Park. And finds it to be very nice. There's a big RC car radio control dirt track, which I think Nomadic Dramatic would probably like. They're going to be that's the only drawback, so be careful. But the ball field here is where all of the fun stuff is going to happen. What did she say? I can't remember the dates. Roughly the third week of January, the 13th through the 23rd or 6th or something. I don't know. Go to homesonwheelsalliance.org to find out the exact dates. But
thank you for watching my video.
You're welcome, Marie. You're welcome. Anyway, so this is it. This is it. Anyway. Anyway, they should get one of those Pope mobiles and Bob could, you know, sit in it and wave to everybody. Hopefully they'll have a good turnout this year. Yeah. But anyway, the camping is all on your own. The camping, well, you can camp wherever you want. Skadden-Wash, Tyson-Wash, Laposa, wherever you can find camping. But don't camp inside the town of Quartzsite because you're not allowed to do that overnight. Hey, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. This is our little show here for the 9th of December, 2021. What did I get? Oh, I wanted. Oh, I got another RV. I got another RV. I want to thank. I would like to thank. I'd like to thank Ether. No. This was an Ether Bunny. Yes, it was. No. This was a Mark. Excuse me. I'm getting my people in North Carolina love my channel. This is Mark. Mark sent me this. Not that Mark. This was sent to me by the Mark in Eastern North Carolina. And he sent me this wonderful, looks like a Class B, right? So I got to open the box. I'll do that. I'll do the unboxing maybe tonight on my live stream. So anyway, well, yeah, I'll do that. That's right. I'm unboxing an RV tonight on my live stream. Hey, I just came up with a really good idea for my live stream tonight. So anyway, I'll be there 7:45, something like that, Eastern. But thank you very much, Mark. I really appreciate it. And he also made a nice little monetary donation. And I got some Christmas cards, too. And we'll talk about those tonight. All right, folks. Thank you so much for watching. I want to thank you for being a friend. Vlog under.